Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta, Azure Mathematics teacher. Today this is our first lecture on class 10th, chapter 3rd. The name of the chapter is a pair of linear equations. What we are going to discuss in this lecture, we take linear equations in one variable form and two variable forms, and we have to find out what is geometrical meanings and why we need such a equations in to calculate the general problems in our daily life. So we have to take some other aspects also. So before to start the video, I request everyone, please listen to me carefully and watch this video from start to end. So let's come our first topic. Our first topic is representation of a linear equation. So in this, firstly we have to represent the equations. We can represent the equation algebraically as well as graphically. So first we have discussed what's the geometrically approach or to represent a general form of a linear equations. So general form of a linear equation can be represented in terms of one variable forms or two variable forms or in three variable form also. But today we are representing a linear equations in one variable form. The one variable form of a linear equations is ax plus b is equal to 0. This is the standard, or you can say that the general form of a linear equations in one variable form, because it is clearly visible here the variable is only one, which is x, and here a and b are your constants. So I am taking here x as a variable, but it is not compulsory. You have to take always a variable as a x. You can take any one other variable, or you can make any alphabet as a variable. The most probable method or to choose the variable name is x, y, and z. So that's why I am taking here x. Now you can also represent in terms of variable y, ax, a y plus b, because in this the variable is your y, and what's a and b? A b are called the constants, but condition is a never be equal to 0, because if a becomes equal to 0, then it eliminates the x. So this becomes just only a constant. It not represents a linear equation. So we cannot, first a never be equal to 0 in this linear equations. I am taking an example. For example, 2x minus 6, this is your standard or general form of a linear equation in one variable. Here x is your one variable. So this is the representation of linear equation in algebraically form. You can calculate and solve for your values for the x. So it gives the zeros of the equations, or you can say that the starting point at which it cut the x axis. So while solving this, you calculate the values of x first. So if we solve this, what we will get? 2x minus 6 goes to the right hand side and it becomes positive 6. If we find out the values of x, it will be 6 divided by 2, which is equal to 3. It means we get the values of 3. This is the algebraically representation as well as the solution of a linear equations. Now we have to do its geometrical representation, or the second topic is our geometrical meaning or the graphical approach, because graphical approach is one of the greatest, or you can say that main tool to solve different types of the problem which can comes in your final exam as well as in final exam as well as in your competitive exam, like your NDA, JEE, and so all the questions are basically based, or you can solve this graphical approach. So graphical approach is main tool of your mathematics. So that's why I am taking the geometrical approach of the representation of a linear equations. So if you get a linear equation, basically linear equations, what is geometrically mean? It represent a linear equation means it represent a straight line equation. What do you mean by straight line? It means if you plot the lines, it gives us straight lines. And also, what's the significance of the straight line? And also, this, please make a note here, it represents a straight line which is either parallel to the x-axis or parallel to the y-axis. Please make a note first here. Whenever you got a linear equation in one variable form, so that must be a straight line representations, and that straight line either to be parallel to x-axis or parallel to y-axis, but not inclined on the both the axis. Again, I repeat, linear equation in one variable form basically represent a straight line. That straight line may be parallel to the x-axis or parallel to the y-axis depending upon the variable. For example, in this I am taking a variable x, so it gives the values of x. If I represent it on a graph, then what's the nature of this? This should be represented a straight line. What's the line? Please, I am drawing here a graph. This is your x-axis, this is negative x-axis, positive y-axis and negative y-axis. And you have to plot this x is equal to 3. It means there is no values of y. So we have to take arbitrary values of y because this x not depends on y. So you can choose any values of y, we get the values of x is always 3. So if I plot this, what I will put? This is your x and this is your y. Or you can say that if I am taking here y and here x, because there is no values of y, if I take y is equal to 0, then the values of x is 3. If I take y is equal to 1, then what's the values of x is? Again 3, because the x is independent of y. Now if I plot this, what's the nature of this graph? It indicates the values of x is 3 and values of y is 0. What's the point is? The values of here, this is called the origin 0, 0. The values of y and x both are 0 at this point. Now we have to plot x is equal to 3. Where is x is equal to 3? Here, x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 0. It means we get a point this. Now second point is, the values of y is equal to 1 and the values of x is 3. It means the values of y1 is here. If we plot here and the values of x, we get another point. If we take another point, suppose y is equal to 2, again we get the values of x is 3. It means if the values of y, we another get the values of x is 3. Now if we plot these points, what will be its nature? If we plot all these points, we get such a line. This line basically represents x is equal to 3, and this line is basically parallel to your y axis because this is your y axis and this is your x is equal to 3. So this line is parallel to your y axis. If I take another example, suppose I am taking here 3y plus 6 is equal to 0. In this again the variable is 1. It means you get here also a straight line which is parallel to either x is equal to 0 or y is equal to parallel to x axis or parallel to y axis. You have to create the same table here. If I create here same table, what I will get? If suppose I am taking x is equal to 0, but here x is not dependent, here y is not dependent on x. So if you put x is equal to 0, what will be the values of y? Values of the y is minus 2. Solve this. 3y is equal to minus 6 and y is equal to minus 2. Now if you have to choose x is equal to 1, and what will be the values of y? Now the again is minus 2. If we choose 2, then again is minus 2 because y is not dependent on x. So whatever the values of the x, the y will be remains same. If we plot this, what will be the nature? Again, the values of x is equal to 0 and y is equal to minus 2. Which means the values of x is equal to 0, but the values of y is minus 2. Again, the values of x is 1, the values of y is minus 2. Again, values of x is 1, but the value of I is minus 2. Now third one is the value of x is positive 2, but the value of y is minus 2. We get another point, this point. Now if we plot them, we get a line. This line represents basically y is equal to minus 2. Y is equal to minus 2, and this is your y-axis. So this line will basically represent parallel to your y-axis. This is parallel to y-axis. So this is the geometrical or graphical approach of a linear equation in one variable form. I hope you understand this video. Please make a note first, then I will take a linear equation in two variable form. Please make a note here, this one variable form gives a line either parallel to x axis and parallel to y axis, not an inclined. At other angle, you can say that it's in this, the angle is always 90 degree, because here if we make angle is 90 degree. In this, the angle is always 90 degree, but not the other angle which is called inclined angle. So make a note first. Now I am going to discuss our next is linear equation in two variable form. What is the general form of a linear equation in two variable form is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. In this clearly visible, we have two variables x and y. So this is why it is called a linear equation, because the both the variables having degree is 1, means the highest power of the variable x and y, both the variables have the highest power is 1. That's why it is called a linear equations. So we have to do both the approach, algebraic approach as well as the graphical approach. What is an algebraic approach? We have to solve using algebraic method. For example, I am taking an example, 2x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. It basically represents a linear equation in two variable form. And what it indicates? It indicates there are so many solutions which indicate that what's the values of x and y on which this equation will be satisfied, means left hand side becomes equal to right hand side. So that are the solution, or you can say that they are linear equation. Again, this equation represent a straight line, but that straight line is not the parallel to x axis or not parallel to y axis, but it is inclined on the x axis. Please make a note. In the previous case, what we were discussed, we discussed a linear equation in one variable form that will be either parallel to x axis or parallel to y axis. But whenever the variables is 2, the equation not will be parallel to x axis or parallel to y axis, but it is inclined to the x axis. How is it? It's algebraically meaning as well as graphically meaning. Please make a note here. Suppose what are the solution? It has so many solutions, because a line constructs a number of points. Points basically indicates that on which the equation is satisfied. For example, if I will take a points 0, 2, is this solution of this linear equation? Question is here. Is this a solution of our linear equations? Answer is your yes. I am asking a question, is this 0, 2 is a solution of this linear equation? I give an answer, yes. Why it is? Because if I take the values of x is here 0 and take the values of y is equal to 2, then this equation must be satisfied. It means left hand side is equal to right hand side. So please make a note here, if we put x is equal to 0, so 2 into 0 plus 3 into y, what's the value of y is 2, minus 6 is equal to 0. 0 plus 6 minus 6, which is equal to 0, is equal to 0, which is 2. It means this point gives a solution of your linear equation. It's so many points. I'm taking another examples. 3, 0. Again the same question. is it solution of your linear equation? So your answer is yes. Why it is yes? Now this left we have to check 2 into x. What's the value of x is 3, and what's the value of y is 0. Minus 6 is equal to 0. 6 minus 6, which is equal to 0. 0 is equal to 0, which is also true. It means we have lots of points, you can say infinite points, which lies on this, on that line, which satisfies these equations. So all those points which satisfy this equation are the solution of your linear equation. I am again repeat, those values of x and y which satisfy these linear equations, left hand side and becomes equal to right hand side, that values of x and y is called the solution, and it has infinite solution because on a line there is infinite number of points exist. Now we have to take its geometrical approach. Geometrically approach, it means we have to locate and we have to plot the line in a graphical form. So we have to take, let the values of x, and corresponding we have to calculate the values of y. Then we have to plot a graph. So I am choosing, for example, x is equal to 0. If I take x is equal to 0, our equation is 2x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. If I am choosing x is equal to 0, it means this becomes 0 plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. We get y is equal to 2. It means we get 2. Now if I choosing x is equal to 3, x is equal to 3, and what's the value of y is, now put it here, 2 into 3 plus 3 into y minus 6 is equal to 0. 2 into 3 is 6, plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. 6 cancel out with 6. 3y is equal to 0 is, means y is equal to 0. We get a point 0. Now take another point. Suppose I am taking here x is equal to 2. Now solve this. 2 into 2 plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. Then 2 to the 4 plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. 3y minus 2 is equal to 0. We get y is equal to 2 by 3. It means y is equal to 2 by 3. These are the solution of this linear equation. If you plot on the graphical paper, then we have to find out its nature. What's the nature of this linear equations? So please make a note first, then I have to plot on this graphical form. Now we have to find out what's the nature of the linear equation in terms of two variables. Now we have to plot this. What's the values of x is 0 and values of y is 2. Then the point is x, the values of x is 0 and y values is 2. We get a point this. Now what's the values of x is 3 and value of y is 0. We get a point this. Values of x is 3 and y values is 0. Now you have to locate the point x is equal to 2 and y value has 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is approximately 0.666. So what we have on this, you must be noted, because by joining any two points, whatever the any place, if you join them, we get a straight line. So naturally this point will also come on that same line. So I am going to plot these lines for making a line this. So naturally this is values of x, and we get here, this is the point x is equal to 2 and y values is 2 by 3. What's the nature it indicates that? This nature indicates that this line is inclined to x axis. It means it makes an angle with the x axis. This is your angle. It means this line is your inclined line. So geometrical meaning indicates that whenever the linear equation in terms of two variable, then basically it indicates a line which is inclined on the x-axis. So it may be cut on the x-axis as well as on the y-axis. So this is the geometrical meaning of your linear equation in two variable form. I hope you understand this. So please make a note first. Then we have to come over on our topic name. We have to discuss here a linear pair of linear equations. In this we have taken only one equations, but the topic starts from the pair of linear equations. It means we have to plot, we have to take not a single equation, we have to take two equations. So then two equations, then what's the nature and what will be effects, so we have to all discuss in this lecture. So please make a note first. Now I am going to take our first question, exercise 3.1. What it states? Aftab tells his daughter, 7 years ago, I was 7 times as old as you were. It means, this indicates that the Aftab age we don't know. And the Aftab age is not connected directly with the his daughter age, because in this 7 years ago, so today, at present, we does not connect, or we have not any relations, so that we can take into one variable form, because there is no relation directly connected with Aftab and his daughter. The age is 7 years ago. That time, that relation is exist, but today at present there is no relations. So that's why there is need of we have to take the Aftab age as well as his daughter is. Again I repeat, because in this we have the need of two variables we have to take in this. In this Aftab is his daughter 7 years ago, it means we have not find the age of its present. This indicates 7 years ago I was 7 times as old as you were then. It means whenever it tells about the Aftab age. Aftab age, we don't know what's the Aftab age. So in this case we have to take the Aftab age as well as his daughter age. We have to assume first, then we have to go 7 years ago. So how we start? Let present age of Aftab is x years. X years. At present age of his daughter y years. Then we are talking to 7 years ago. This is a present age. So 7 years ago, Aftab age will be 7 less. It means today or current or present age is x. Then 7 years means x minus 7 years. And his daughter is y minus 7 years, because we are talking 7 years ago. So both the age subtract by 7 years. Now what's the relation before 7 years? I basically indicate for the Aftab. It means according to question, Aftab age was 7 times, it means 7 multiplied as old as you were there. You were indicates basically his daughter. His daughter. Now put the values of Aftab age is x minus 7. 7 multiply his daughter age is y minus 7. If we solve this, what we will got? We got x minus 7 is equal to 7 into y, 7 by 7 into 7 minus 49. Now solve this, take it every terms on the left hand side. X minus 7 minus 7y plus 49 is equal to 0. Then further solve this, x minus 7y minus 7 plus 49, which is plus 42. Plus 42 is equal to 0. This is our equation number 1. Please make a note first. I write our first equation here. X minus 7y plus 42 is equal to 0. In the similar manner, we have to make our second equation. What's the second equation state? Please read the statement. Also, 3 years from now, it means this question asks the age, future age. It means we have to add 3 years later. So, 3 years later. What's the age of Aftab? Aftab age, present age is X. After 3 years, it becomes X plus 3. His daughter is, today is Y, and after 3 years, it becomes Y plus 3. Now, what's the condition? Here indicates I shall be, it means I means Aftab is 3 times, it means 3 multiply as old as you. Old means his daughter. Daughter is according to question. Now substitute this value. Aftab age is x plus 3, which is equal to 3 multiply daughter age. Daughter age is y plus 3. Now solve this. X plus 3. X plus 3 is equal to 3 multiply y. 3y, 3 multiply 3, we get 9. Now take all the values on the left hand side. X plus 3 minus 3y minus 9 is equal to 0. Now x minus 3y plus 3 minus 9, we get minus 6 is equal to 0. This is our second equation. So please make a note first, then I will wrap the whole portion, because now we have to take our first equation and find, because these two equations represent basically algebraically, because question asks us represent this algebraically, so we already represent our the question in algebraically form. Now we have to go our next second step, we have to represent it also in graphical form. So we do our next step. So make a note first. So I write our both the equation, these two equations represent your algebraic form. So first our part is complete. Now we have to represent in graphical form. So we have to create a table first. So how we create a table? So in this firstly we have to create a table so that we can plot the values of the x and y, and we get a straight line. So in this, whenever you try to plot the graph, we have to need only 2 points, because by joining 2 points we can draw a straight line. So there is no need to more than 2 points we have to find out. So for simplicity we have to find only 2 points. First point you can easily find out if you put x is equal to 0, and second point easily find out if you put y is equal to 0. In first case we have to put x is equal to 0, in second case we have to put y is equal to 0. If the values we have to, you will found it's complex, it is in form of points, then you can choose another values also. Let's try. Here I am choosing x here is y. If I choose values of x is 0, then what will be the result? I put x is equal to 0. 0 minus 7 y plus 42 is equal to 0. Take it on the right hand side, 7 y is equal to 42 by a 7, 42 by 7, which is equal to 6. It means we get y is 6. Now second case, we have to put y is equal to 0. In this we put x is equal to 0. Now put y is equal to 0. If I put y is equal to 0, then what is the value? X minus 7 into 0 plus 42 is equal to 0. So x plus 42 is equal to 0, x value is equal to minus 42. X value is minus 42 and y value is 0. It means we get a point, x is equal to minus 42 and y is equal to 0. But we have to ignore this because we have to locate minus 42 on our number line, which is very difficult. So in this we have to choose some another value of x. So now I am going to represent the values of y. Suppose I am choosing values of y is, I am solving here, y is equal to 6. Suppose if I choose y is equal to 6, then what's the value of 6? 7 into 6 minus plus 42 is equal to 0. X, 7 into 6, 42 plus 42 is equal to 0. It means 0. We get x is equal to 0. We get the same point. It means we have to try another point. So please make a look first and try what's the values we can be choose. So if I choose the values for x is 7. If I choose the values of x is 7, then what's the values of y is? Put it here. X is 7 minus 7 y plus 42 is equal to 0. Minus 7 y goes to right side, plus 7 y, 42 plus 7 which is equal to 49. What's the value is 49 by 7 which is 7. It means we get y is equal to 7. So if I put x values is 7, I get the values of y is also 7. So we get 2 points and now we can easily plot. Please make a note first. Now we have to find only 2 points because 2 points is enough to plot your straight lines. Now the same step we have to do in the second equation also. The step is same. Firstly we have to put x is equal to 0 and make a table. I am making a table here. This is x, this is y. First case is put x is equal to 0 and calculate the values of y. Now I am putting x is equal to 0 in this. 0 minus 3 into y minus 6 is equal to 0. Now take it, minus 3y goes to right side, it becomes positive, we get negative 6. And what's the values of y is? Minus 6 divided by 3, minus 2. Means the values of y is minus 2. We choose x is equal to 0 and get the values of y is minus 2. Now second step is, now put y is equal to 0. Here we put x is equal to 0. Now put y is equal to 0 and check the values. X minus 3 into 0 minus 6 is equal to 0. This is x minus 6 is equal to 0. X is equal to 6. So we get easily value. Suppose if we get a value which is not possible to plot, then we have to take another values by thinking or by our assuming method. By using this can be improved by using practice. What's the value on which we get easiest value? So you have to get the easiest value so that you can plot on the graph paper. So in this we get the 6 and we can plot 6 as values. So here we have to take values of y is 0 and the what's the values of x is 6. It means we got a table of 2 points. 2 points is coefficient. Now we have to locate all these into our graph paper. So I am taking one by one. Firstly, I am plotting our line x minus 7y plus 42 is equal to 0. Locate it. The values of x is 0 and values of y is 6. It means we have to plot a point. I am going to plot a point. First point is 0 comma 6. The values of x is 0 and the values of y is 6. Where it is? The values of x is 0 and the values of y is 6. It means we get a point here. Now our second point is the values of x is 7 and the values of y is also 7. It means the values of x is here 7 and the values of y is here 7. It means we get here a point. This point is your A and this point is your B. Now join these 2 points and draw a line. If I join these points, we get a line. So please give a name here. X minus 7y plus 42 is equal to 0. This is our first line. Now the same process we have to follow for our second line. Our second line gives the values of x is 0. It means I am locating the point C. The values of x is 0 and the values of y is minus 2. It means we have to plot x is equal to 0 here and values of y is minus 2. It means we get a point this. This is your C point. Now we have to take our another point D. The values of x is 6 and values of y is 0. So where it is? The values of x is 6 and values of y is 0. It means we get a point this. Now join this. This is your second line. Now give some name. X minus 3y plus minus 6 is equal to 0. So this is the graphical representation of the solution of your question 1. So please make a note here. In this we get 2 lines. And if we represent these 2 lines on a plane, on a paper, then what's the nature and what's the information we get from these 2 lines? Firstly, you have to think and I will explain it. Again, I give a question you. Here we get 2 lines. So, in this we have to bend or move these lines. What type of nature, what you observe from these 2 lines? If we plot it on our paper. Again, I am repeating the question. If you have 2 lines and you have to plot it on our paper, graph paper, then what's the points you will observe? So please think and I will explain. And please make a note first. So now my question is what? Whenever we plot 2 straight lines on the graph paper, what you will observe? I hope you will be think. Suppose this whole is your graphical paper and I am plotting 2 lines, then what's the nature of these 2 lines? Please make a look. Suppose this is your line first, and if we get another line, the lines may be like form. Please make a look here. Because we plot two lines. The lines may be this shape. And please make a look here. These lines, what indicate? These lines indicate basically parallel nature. It means these two lines never intersect at any point. If we extend it in any direction of at any length, these lines never intersect. So first nature, if we plot these two lines, so we it's possible to get a lines of parallel. So we get parallel lines. Second case, suppose our first line is this. This means your line 1, line 2. This is our case first. Our case second. Now, this is your first line. And second line may be like this. This is your line 2. Because the lines may become in such manner. So what it indicates? It indicates basically lines intersect at any point. So these lines are called intersecting lines. So second nature is intersecting. This nature is parallel line. Now intersecting lines. So lines may be intersecting also. Or assume another case. What's the case is? Like this is our first line, and if we got our second lines, it may be on the same line. What's the nature means? Suppose this is our graph paper. This is x-axis and this is y-axis. I have a line which has a point. Suppose first line is your x-y. X value is 0, y value is 2. X value is 2, y value is 4. If you plot such, the values of x is 0, the values of y is 2, it means this point. The values of x is 2, what's the values of y is? 4. Or suppose now if you locate them and plot them, we get this nature. This is our line first. Now I am going to plot our next line. Line 2. X and Y. If I put X is equal to 0, again I get 2. If I put 2, I get again 4. So it means we get same point on both the lines. So then how the procedure we locate them? It means all these lines are on the same line. It means they are basically represent a same line but different proportions. Means the values is same. You are hearing, you are here confusing. So we take by it by examples. So this concept may be clear in whenever we takes our question. Means when one lines overlap with the another lines, that lines may be get whenever we locates our two lines. For example, suppose if you, I am changing here, this is your A point and this one is your B point, A and B. Suppose whenever the point in x is minus 2, and we get y is 0. It means where is the point? When x is minus 2, x is minus 2 and y is 0, it means this point also lies on the same line. Now I am taking x is equal to 4, we get 6. This is point C, this is point D. C and D. This is AB. This AB line represented by your first line, and CD line represented by line 2. But all the lines AB and CD, both are overlapping each other. So these lines may be obtained whenever we plot our lines in graphical form. So don't be confused there. That's maybe solution of these lines. That type of lines is called coincident lines. Coincident lines. Again, I repeat, whenever you plot the lines may be look like your rails. It means they represented like a parallel form. They never intersect at any point if we extend to any length. And second nature we can obtain. We can obtain either these two lines intersect at any points like this. Whenever we plot two lines, it may be possible that two lines intersect at any point. That also your correct answer. Third case may be also exist. Whenever we plot two lines and all the points of our line 1 and line 2 occur on a single line. Again I repeat, whenever you plot two lines and both the points, or you can say that all the points lie on a single line, that means two lines are overlapping each other. These lines are called coincident lines. Coincident lines. What its meaning actually? Whenever two lines comes in parallel form, it means they never intersect. It means no point is common between these two lines. I am repeating. No common points between them. There is no common point between both of these lines. That means there is no solution. Geometrically means no solution. Our next exercise, we have to find out the solution. How we get the solution, we will discuss in our next exercise. But the solution is possible or not, you can say that if the lines nature, whenever we plot the graph and lines looks like parallel, so you can clearly say that according to a graphical nature, lines has no solution, means there is no points common that in bit on the lines A and B, because the lines A and B are different place, so no point will be common, so that there is no solution. Whenever we are talking about intersecting lines, it means this line intersect at a point. This is called intersecting points, and this is a single point common. This means single point common. We got only a single point common. Single point common means when the line intersecting, we get a point. Get a point means we have only a single solution. So we have a unique solution. So always keep in mind, when the lines are intersecting, we get only a one solution, and one solution is only unique. Third case is, whenever we got two lines overlapping each other. These lines are called coincident lines. And what are the solution? What are the common points? As you know, if the lines are overlapping each other, it means all the points are common. I am taking A, B, C, D. All the points are lies on both the lines. Because we can increase it in any direction. And we have take so many points, like I am taking here points here, here, here. I can take infinite points, and all the points are common in both the lines, A lines and B lines. So it gives us infinite number of solutions. It gives infinite number of solutions. So please make a note this. Again I repeat, in short, if the lines are parallel, then we get no solutions. There is no common point between lines 1 and 2. Second case, if the lines are intersecting, we get only one point, and one point gives us only one solution, and that solution is called unique. Third case is when the lines are overlapping each other, which is called coincident lines. It gives us infinite number of points. It means we have infinite number of solutions. This is the main important point that you have to keep in your mind. So please make a note first. So I'm taking our second question. The coach of a cricket team buys 3 bats and 6 balls for rupees 3900 rupees. Later she buys another bats and 2, it means 1 bat and 2 balls of same kinds of rupees 1300. It means we have two equations. In terms of first that she, the coach purchased, and then later what the coach purchased. So first we have to take assume what's the cost price of a bat and what's the cost price of a ball. So please make a note first. Let cost of bat is rupees X, cost of ball is rupees Y. So our according to question, what it said? 3 bat. The cost of 1 bat is X rupees. Then the cost of 3 bat is 3 into X. 3 into X plus 6 ball. The cost of 1 ball is cost of X 1. 1 bat and 1 ball is Y. Then the cost of 6 ball is 6 into Y. And total price we have to pay is 3900. It means which is equal to 3900. This is our equation first. Now read second. Another bet, it means one bet, and the cost of one bet is X plus two balls. It means the price of one ball is Y, so price of two ball is 2Y. We have to pay 1300 rupees. It means we got our second equation. Now we have to solve, and the procedure is same as we already discussed. Firstly, we have to put x is equal to 0 and get the values of y and make a table. So do it yourself. I am also doing. Please make a note first. So I am right here our two equations, and we have to do the same step. First one is put x is equal to 0. Put x is equal to 0. 0 plus 2 into y is equal to 1300. We get, if we divide by 1300 divided by 2, we get 2 6 are 12, 2 5 is 650. It means if we put x is equal to 0, we find the value of x, y is 650. Now same here, put y is equal to 0. What we will get? X is x plus 2 into 0, which is equal to 1300. So values of x is 1300. Means whenever y is 0, x is 1300. But it is very typical because we have to locate 1300. It means we have to locate 1300 blocks. So we have to think someone x. So please do it yourself. Now I am taking the same step here. If x is equal to 0, put x is equal to 0, but we will put 3 into 0 plus 6 into y is equal to 3900. This is 6y is equal to 3900. So y is equal to 3900 divided by 6. Now cut it. 6, 6 are 36. Carry 3. 6, 5 is 30. It means we get 650. So values of x is 0. We get 650. Now please make a note. X is 0. Y is 650. Again in this case, x is 0. Y is 650. It means this line must be going to a coincident lines. Now put y is equal to 0. If y is equal to 0, 3x plus 0 is equal to 3900. So 3x is equal to 3900. So x is equal to 3900 upon with 3, which is 1300. It means same y value is 0, we get 1300. It means these lines are coincident lines. So you have to, if you will take another point also, sorry, I'm again taking some of points also different from these points. Like, please make a think again different values from this. Now if I put another value, x is equal to 100, then what will be the result? Put x is equal to 100, then 100 plus 2 into y is equal to 1300. So 2y is equal to 1300 minus 100, which is equal to 1200. So what will be the value? Y is equal to 1200 divided by 2, which is equal to 600. Means we get 600. Now plot this point. This indicates very clearly because the points are common. So these lines are must be coincident. Firstly, the value of x is 0 and y is 650. Value of x is 0. Value of y is 650. It means the points come here in between 600 and 700. Value of x is 100. Value of y is 600. X value is 100 and the value of this. If you plot them, we get such a point. Times. Now if you plot them, x is equal to 0, what's the value of y is? Again this. This is our line first. And value of 1300, the value of y becomes 0. It means if we plot this in a similar manner, this line must be cut on 1300. Now take another one example. If I take x is equal to 300, or x is equal to, suppose I am taking x is equal to 100. X is equal to 100, then what will be the value? 3 into 100 plus 6 into y, which is equal to 3900. It means 300 plus 6y is equal to 3900. 6y is equal to 3900 minus 300, which is equal to 3600. So 6y, so y we get 3600 divided by 6, we get 600. Again the same value. It means we get 100 and 6. It means both the lines are overlapping. That's why I am writing 4 arrowhead. So it begins, lines are overlapping, meaning coincident So these lines are coincident. So by graphically or geometrically we can find the nature of the lines, either intersecting, parallel or coincident lines. So according to the whole steps are same whenever we will take our next question. So next question you have to do it yourself. It's very easy. You have to do all the steps are same. So please make a note first. I request everyone, if you really like this video is good for you and for your friends also, so do subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. Also please I require to do like also, because whenever you do likes, this video goes to your different friends, with your neighbor's friends. So I request, if you like my video, so do subscribe as well as do like. And I have taken this question from your NCERT, and you are also reading from another books like R.D. Sharma and R.S. Agarwal and another books, and you have to put some question, and you want me to prepare another video for some required solutions for particular topics, so I will try my level best. So you can comment me on my YouTube channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes, or you can WhatsApp me your problem. My WhatsApp number is 9671632413, and you can take your screenshot of your problem and send to my WhatsApp number, or you can also email me. My email ID is gaurav6gaurav6.gupta@gmail.com. So you can send your problem list on my email ID as well as WhatsApp number. So according to your problem, according to your comments, I will prepare myself for our next video. So thank you once again for watching my video from start to end. So don't forget to subscribe my channel, and don't forget to like. Then we will make as soon as when I make our next video.